25 years ago, as today, the coming of spring ushered in the tornado season. One twister still remembered for its sudden, shattering fury hit Metropolis, Illinois. In a twinkling, tons of bricks from the ruined buildings showered down from the skies. A 100-foot swath was cut through the town. Many were the hairbreadth escapes from death in the disaster that ravaged Metropolis with whirlwind speed. On the 20th anniversary of the opening of the Universal City Studios, a host of old-timers lined up to congratulate movie pioneer Carl Laemmle. It was a grand reunion of the industry, from the earliest stars of the silent screen to the up-and-coming figures of 25 years ago. Gadgeteers seem more active a quarter of a century back. Witness this combination police revolver and movie camera, invented by O.W. Atkins of Los Angeles. Just the thing for making gangster films. To discourage false alarms, the Cleveland Fire Department tested a cunning contrivance that automatically manacled anyone sending an alarm. Seemed like a good idea all around, the only catch being it discouraged genuine alarms, too. Who'd put his hand into that thing? On Lake Erie, an auto gyro engineer tested a nifty idea that would make sails obsolete. The wind turned the giant rotor, and the rotor was geared to a propeller below the waterline. Very neat, but the speedboaters didn't need it, and the sailboaters didn't want it. Five years ago, Miss America met not beauty, but speed. Miss America 10th was the world's fastest speedboat. And when Garwood brought her to Miami's Biscayne Bay, the country watched with fascination as he scorched along at 118 miles an hour, faster than the airplane overhead, for a new saltwater record.